So my name is Nidhi and my today's topic is discrimination based on physical appearance. Now what this cartoon represents here is very interesting. What we see is two skeletons blaming each other, one for being too thick and the other for being too thin. But the sad part is this is not limited to the entertainment this cartoon offers us. This is all around us without even realizing it. So, as you can figure out, the topic here is body shaming. So, when I looked at the causes, when I analyzed the causes, so the first cause I came up with was we don't realize the impact that our words had. Oh my God, she's so skinny. And oh my God, she is so fat. You need to lose some weight. These are statements we say unconsciously without even realizing it. It is terrifying how ingrained as a part of society it has become to the extent that we have normalized body shaming. Body shaming as an issue has gripped our society by crippling one of the most important and core values, which is acceptance. The second cause I could recognize here was that what we are taught as children shapes into what we believe as an adult. As a child, we're told, you need to be perfect. You know what? You need to be a good kid. You need to look a certain way and you need to think about, oh, you know what? What will people think when they see you like this? You better lose some weight or else you won't have any friends. And justified that this shapes our opinions, actions and choices as an adult as well. It is curious how we say the definition of beauty is so subjective. Beauty should be what defines you, not controls your life. But yet, it has turned so objective. And it isn't what we are realizing now. This has been a culture since decades. You should lose weight, they said. It will be all right. That is what they said, right? But more than often, we don't realize the impact that these statements carry. The impacts of these kind of discrimination which is faced by people range from simple acts such as not liking yourself to the likes of depression and even suicide. The first thing, when a person is told, oh, you know what, you need to lose weight, the first thought is, I should stop eating. And this is a very critical mindset which often leads to the development of eating disorders, with the most common one being anorexia. Over 40% of college girls who have been told to lose weight have developed some form of anorexia later in their life. The second impact is the low self-esteem which that person carries. The moment a person is criticized on their physical appearance, such a vital and significant part of their identity, is the moment which they lose their worth as individuals, at the moment which they fail to realize that they are important and their voice matters. They fail to realize that, oh, we don't need to change for the society to accept us, but it is the society which needs to change for them to accept us. The third is, you've all seen a child being excluded out of the football field. Oh my God, how can you play sports? You're so fat. You'll surely make the team lose, isn't it? And we have all seen children being targeted along the lines of nothing but their weight. This is what leads to them being socially conscious and unaccepting of themselves in the first place. Hence, I come to the conclusion that social isolation is a big impact of body shaming. And social isolation only amplifies the problem further by not allowing the person who is going through that kind of discrimination to vent out their feelings, to get somebody to understand them, to get somebody to care for them, and to get somebody to guide them. And the last, but definitely not the least, we have a thing of reduced productivity. When we see in children, you'll see an academic decline in their performance, and for adults, a loss of productivity in the workplace. The next aspect I wanted to explore in this was, how does social media fuel this issue further? Now, I'm not saying that social media drives this issue, but the thing is, it does fuel it. Let me give you an example. You want to get 5 shades fairer? Try this fairness cream. You want to look like a model? Try this diet tea. Guaranteed results within 3 weeks. these are often one of the first things we see when we log on to internet or any social media site. Unfair representation has become nothing short of a culture in the past decades. And this includes unfair representation of people of color, unfair representation of different body types, and unfair representation of gender norms. But considering body types, we always see perfect looking people on our screen, but what we fail to realize is that those are not what we should aspire to look like. So the thing is, social media cannot always be negative. Let's take the example of the recent body positivity movement, which was launched and had gained a lot of momentum on social media. This was because many people finally broke through the stigma of being body shamed. You still don't believe that this all can happen, and how can our issue be brought to light? Can I have a show of hands and see how many of you know who is Caitlin Ohashi, if any? She was the best gymnast in the world. It's simple, right? The point is, she was the best until she wasn't. After she retired, she came up about the several issues. She told she was measured each day and she was told to eat less until she was supposedly fit enough to practice. So what happens is very real and can impact a person to the extent that somebody can never ever imagine. But the thing is, we created this problem, so there has to be a solution. What we can do firstly is start by accepting yourself and then accepting others. Make sure you are never the one commenting on how somebody looks like, be it on their body type or physical deformity or their skin color, something which is definitely not in their control. Secondly, if you see that happening, intervene immediately. Your one action could help somebody so much that you can never imagine. Thirdly, use the power that social media grants you wisely. This is a very clear example of how it can be used. Fourthly, encourage fair representation in all areas of life, be it entertainment, be it sports, be it academics, or be it your own life. Fair representation is important, and that is when we'll come to acknowledge that all shapes and sizes and all skin colors are beautiful no matter what. And on this note, I'd like to end with a poem. You're not your weight. You're not the size of the last meal you ate. You're not the size of clothes you wear or the color of your hair. You're not all the hate you receive. You're not the impact. You are the impact which you leave. What changed was you were beautiful was what you forgot, and you chose to define yourself by what others told you, all the things you're not. Thank you.